out along country roadsides, you'll sometimes come across a rather stunted and tatty-looking acacia shrub, surrounded by a lot of excited butterflies. They're probably the butterflies called Imperial Blues, and it's well worth stopping to see exactly what it is they're doing there. Most of these butterflies are males. They're hanging around these acacia bushes for a good reason. There's a whole lot of female butterflies about to emerge, and the competition is likely to be fierce. The focus of interest is these blackish-looking pupae crowded together on the stem. That's where the females will be coming from. A few are already out and mating, and excitement is high. Incidentally, if you're wondering why these butterflies are known as blues, here's the reason. They really are blue, but only on top of the wings. You'll notice lots of little black ants running about, but they don't bother these butterflies a bit. In fact, the ants are vitally important to their survival. But let's start at the beginning. This butterfly is checking out an acacia as her egg-laying site. She's using special sense organs on her abdomen to smell out information. Is this a suitable food plant for her caterpillar? Is it regularly visited by ants? And are they the right kind of ants? When she's satisfied, she lays her eggs on the stem. These caterpillars are almost fully grown, big enough to make a succulent meal, but not for the ants swarming about on them. They're friendly. In fact, they're the caterpillar's security guards, their guarantee of safety. No predators will attack her caterpillars while the ants are about. In fact, if the butterfly had chosen an acacia without ants, she could have lost up to 100% of her offspring. Well, that's marvelous for the caterpillars, but what do the ants get out of it? They get paid for their protection. Their activity stimulates glands on the caterpillar's body to produce tiny droplets of liquid. It's a kind of honeydew containing sugars for energy and amino acids for growth. And the ants can't get enough of it. Even when the caterpillars pupate, the ants still get their reward. No more carbohydrates, but still those vital amino acids. Payment stops only when the butterflies emerge and the ants are no longer needed. The male butterflies know by scent when an emergence is due. At the first crack of a pupal shell, there's a great flurry of colliding wings as they home in on it. There's no attempt at courtship with these males. They're simply too busy jostling among themselves. Emerging females have little time to unfurl their wings and make themselves presentable. They're set upon by a pack of frenzied males, and it looks a little rough for a time. But it's the males that get their elegant wings torn, and only one of them succeeds in mating. This male's simply wasting his time. But I'd say by his torn wings and bedraggled appearance, he's already had his day. The fluttering wings of this female indicate rejection. She's probably mated already. The male persists for a while, but in the end, such signals are always respected. But there's no such signal when one male attempts to mate with another in the general confusion. After all this frenzied mixing and matching, the male butterflies will simply disappear. The females will go off for a leisurely feed among the flowers. Then it'll be time to check the local acacias for a good firm of security guards. If you have a small acacia or wattle tree growing in your garden, and if it's the right kind, you might find some of those caterpillars making a bit of a mess of it one summer. Don't spray them. There's a much better solution. Just plant another wattle tree, and then you'll have a double dose of those beautiful butterflies flying around your garden.